This is CatAList, Oxy's television network, bringing you the A-list in Oxy's news and entertainment.
What's up, everybody? I'm Desiree Jaton, and that's my man, Eric Leader. And this week on What You Like, we're talking about how to end it. We're talking about the worst ways, the best ways, and the funny-ass ways to end a relationship and to get a new boo. Here's what people around the campus had to say.
The worst way to break up with someone is probably changing your Facebook status.
The worst way is to hear it from somebody else.
Hearing from their weekend hookup that you guys weren't seeing each other anymore.
On their birthday, when it's their birthday party, at their birthday party, would probably be the worst one.
If I was gonna break up with someone the worst way possible, I would take them out on a really nice date, order a lot of food, wait for the check to come, take the check, instead of signing my name, write I'm breaking up with you, then excuse myself to the bathroom and bounce.
Text message is definitely the worst way to break up with someone.
Email's also pretty inconsiderate.
Most unclassy way to break up with someone is via text message. That's just low.
Funniest way is probably the Ryan and Kelly way to send the text to Darryl.
My boy once hired a skywriter to break up with his girl.
So let's say you're in a group and you guys are all playing telephone, and so then your significant other's next to you. So then you whisper it and it goes around and around and around and around and around, and it gets to that person, they're like, Tommy's breaking up with me, and it's like, wait, and then it's like,
Worst way to break up with a girl?
Yeah.
During sex.
Handed a handwritten note while getting a blowjob and then read it.
Taking them out to a nice seafood dinner and then never calling them again.
Tell the girl that you're gay.
You explain how much you love them and then you just say, actually, no.
When I was in seventh grade, a boy gave a note to his friend to give to his girlfriend. Breaking up with her, and he spelled her name wrong.
Breaking up with someone in the library would be terrible, because once you break up with them in the library, they can't even be loud and cry, because they have to be quiet.
Make sure the girl signs a contract ending all relations.
This week's events are presented by TOA. All this week, the ICC presents To Live and Die in L.A. Jonathan Alter from Newsweek is speaking about Obama Monday at 6 in Johnson. Don't like grad school? There's a post-Oxy seminar Wednesday at 12:30. Gabor Kalman presents his documentary There Was Once Thursday at 7. Film Club is showing Inception Friday at 8:30 in Johnson. Support H2Oxy in buying a bracelet on Saturday night in the Greek Pool. And this week's producer's pick is Battle of the Bands, Saturday night in the Greek Pool, free Kobe and live music. And all you clubs out there, remember, if you need a ride, call the Bengal Bus. And for print advertising, simply contact TOA, the Occidental Agency.
Hi, I'm Hillary Holmes with On the Quad. Today we're talking about unisex clothing. Have gender roles and fashion gone completely out the window? With guys wearing girl clothes and girls wearing guy clothes? Let's see what people have to say. Talking about unisex clothing, I have a question for you. Would you ever go into your, and this is fully
hypothetical.
Would you ever go into your girlfriend's closet and like steal some of her pants?
Yeah, no, absolutely. I think a lot of it, I think I'm like secure with my sexuality. I don't need to necessarily prove anything to anyone. I like clothes that fit, so yeah.
The answer would be no.
Why?
Because those pants are way too tight for my style.
So what is your style?
I kind of just wear whatever I want. And at the end of the day, like, they're just clothes. Whoever wears them, doesn't define that much.
Kind of more macho, you could say.
Obviously, I'm wearing stripes and flannel. Someone alerted me to that earlier this morning, but I guess I don't really follow.
Yeah, fashion, no.
Yeah, I guess I don't really follow conventional style guidelines.
And so you wouldn't be opposed if like your girlfriend came into your closet and borrowed some clothes and vice versa?
Oh, hell no. Absolutely not. I think it's something to be comfortable with.
So that's all for this week. Join me next time for On the Quad.
We're just sitting here early Friday night, after that last midterm, loosen up and feel alright. Let's relax and play a game.
drink, it ain't fun, but it's all the same.
Let's turn on a couple of tunes. No, wait, I got my bass bassoon. Hey, you kids in your room, you quit playing that bass bassoon. We done got a noise complaint. No, you playing them beer pong games.
Officer, I'm 21.
She ain't though.
Is that a red cup? I'm taking you in.
Campus safety for the win.
Conduct blues
from breaking all the rules.
Conduct blues,
better stay off that booze.
Time to find out this week's poll question. Which celebrity would you choose to party with? Kanye West, Taylor Swift, Lady Gaga, or Justin Bieber?
I don't need too much, just somebody to love. I don't need nothing else, I promise, girl, I swear, I just need somebody to love.
Do you know this tiger? Like I know this tiger?
I am a member of Pulse, which is the student-run hip-hop club on campus. I'm one of the executive board members, and I'm also one of the choreographers. It's every Monday night from 8 to 10 in the dance studio. 8 to 9 is the beginner class, 9 to 10 is the intermediate. Yes, that is a plug. You should all come to Pulse. I had never danced before coming to Oxy, and then halfway through my sophomore year, I started going to Pulse, and I fell in love with dance, and it really fit my personality.
The costumes, the scenery, the makeup, the props, the audience that lifts you when you're down.
When I dance, I can, like, just completely lose myself in it. And that's not just, like, while I'm dancing. I mean, like, if I'm dancing enough in a given week, I just, like, lose myself to thinking about dance all the time. Don't tell my teachers this, but I don't even care about school here anymore. I'm kind of still here because I love to dance so much, and like the dance community has become my family. It kind of defines me at this point a lot more than my major and my academic work. It's funny how when you're in college, you find out what really like means a lot to you, even if it's not school. Like what brings us together is school, but what we choose to do with our time outside of that really has nothing to do with it for some of us. Some people are in the library like 24/7. I'm more likely to be in the dance studio than I am in the library. I've spent probably half an hour in the library this semester, and I was like hanging out and like picking up a book, and on a given day I've probably spent an hour or two in the dance studio. So that's just a little peek into my life.
Hey guys, welcome to another episode of Awkward Starfish. I'm Jonathan.
And I'm Adriana.
And I'm Taylor. This week, we'll be using Gumby.
Thank you.
You're watching CatAList, Season 1, Episode 8. Stay tuned for more shows.
The library is a tree of wisdom where the fruits of knowledge are ripe for the picking.
Mark the 18th of November on your calendars, for upon that day, the annual library book sale will begin.
Approximately 3,000 books will be available for purchase at a very reasonable price.
Paperbacks will be sold for 25 cents, while the more hardcore hardbacks will wager $1 apiece.
The book sale will be open to Oxy students this Thursday and to the general community Friday and Saturday.
The first 250 customers shall receive a free, durable shopping tote crafted with the use of reused plastic bottles.
Don't miss out on this wonderful chance to recycle knowledge.
And at a wonderful price.
What's the word on the street? Foxy dances.
It's good that we have dances. It would be cool if we had more of them, I guess.
To be eloquent, I think they've become a little one note. Oxy dances. I generally don't go to the Oxy dances. I did a lot freshman year until I discovered that they were all pretty much the same thing over and over again.
I absolutely love Oxy dances.
I've only been to one Oxy dance, but I had an amazing time.
I've heard in the past the dances have been awesome and they made like Playboy's top whatever list of something, which doesn't really mean that much to me.
I think they are so much fun. Half the time I'll be dancing by myself in the corner, but I absolutely love it.
I'm not a huge fan of the music that they play at them, which never changes. And I'm also not a huge fan of watching people practically get it on right in front of me.
I don't really like dances. The music pretty much sucks without fail, and the couples are really obnoxious.
I'd rather they got a room.
As far as I'm aware, there have only been like two or three dances that I've heard of. I definitely would like to see more of them.
It's a great vibe, even though half the time pretty much everyone is pretty drunk, but I have such a good time, so I love them.
I think they're pretty good, but I don't have any points of comparison. I haven't attended dances at other schools.
I just know that when I go there, I regret being sober.
I don't really feel the need to try them again. I doubt they've changed.
I can only hope that we strive to have better dances and more dances in the future.
And that's the word.
On today's episode,
MPX
are brought to you by the letters he,
B,
and J.
Here's a little known secret. If you're on a budget, in the marketplace, it's actually cheaper to make your own PB&J than to buy a pre-made one.
First, you pick the kind of bread you want.
Then, you grab a serving of peanut butter from on top of the sandwich cooler, and however much jelly you want from the tub.
You can mix it up if you want. Instead of jelly, I love to put banana and honey in my sandwiches. If you've never tried a PB, B, and H, give it a try.
Up madness, Sienna and I review the carrot muffin.
That's really good.
Yeah.
Oh boy. I really like this one. Like a sweet bread. It's really moist and really, really tasty.
Yeah. It took a while for it to hit my mouth. Once it did, there was no turning back.
I really like this muffin. I would give this like a 9. Maybe 9.3.
I think I, too, would give this a 9. It's, I think it's substantial for a muffin. And it's
It's carrot, so it's healthy.
Hey everyone, my name is Anthony Green.
And I'm Emily Webb.
And we're standing outside of Newcomb Hall where we're about to film our next episode of Room Raiders.
Oxy Edition.
We're standing outside of Newcomb Room 108.
And we are about to find out Reza's dirty little secrets.
Room service! You're on Room Raiders, bitch!
Hey Reza, is there anything you'd like to get off your chest before we raid your room?
Everything has a perfectly logical explanation. I have nothing to hide.
You sure about that?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, well, let's raid this room.
Handcuffs? Who needs an RA with this disciplinarian?
What do we have behind the TV? Someone's ready for a Mexican wrestling match.
Gotta watch out for that LA smog.
Get your gas mask out.
Okay, Reza, we have been through your room and we found some pretty interesting things. One of which I'm wearing. Can you talk about this mask that I'm wearing right now?
The Lucha Libre mask was a joke gift given to me by a friend of our parents, saying if I wanted to blend in with the local crowd of LA.
Okay, another item we found was a... what is this?
It's a homemade lightsaber done by one of my friends.
And what about this gas mask?
Same deal as the Lucha Libre mask. It was the joke gift along with the other mask, saying that LA air quality was that bad.
Black light attack. Clean.
Check out this week's forecast.
Wingman.
What? That's my wife! And why does your voice keep changing? I don't even know you anymore, mate! Well, that's what you're talking about! And you look ridiculous, mate!
I look ridiculous? You look ridiculous! How do you have a farmer's tan? You don't even wear sleeves!
Screw you, mate! I'm leaving!
Bud! Come on in!
Is there... Jenga?
Sure is! Sit up right over there, mate! Well, let me show you the room first. This is my bed.
Burn, I think it's time you leave, mate.
Okay. but I'm gonna keep this as a souvenir.
I need a new brother. Alright, all you have to do is say, I crumba, mate.
I crumba!
No, 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 that's not right.
What?
Next! Next! Next!
CatAList is brought to you by and a special thanks to